to the Aquarium Adventure Club. Today we're wondering, what does animal poop poop?
Octopus poop.
Crab poop.
Turtle poop.
Lobster poop.
Penguin poop.
Jellyfish poop.
Shark poop.
Leopard shark poop.
Whale poop.
Otter poop.
Stingray poop.
Sea lion poop.
So much poop!
I don't even know where to start.
We need a poop expert.
The professor of poop.
Someone who can give the scoop on poop.
I'm not actually a professor of poop, but as staff veterinarian here at Shedd Aquarium, I am a bit of an expert.
Dr. Matt, do you have any favorite poops?
Favorite isn't really the right word for it, but there are a lot of really interesting animal poops out there. There's sandy poop, which we get from the parrotfish, who love eating coral. Their stomachs break down the coral into smaller pieces, and then sand comes out the other end. So those beautiful white sand beaches are actually the result of parrotfish poop. And then there's upside-down poop. Because a sea star's mouth is on its underside and its butt is on top, so when they poop, it comes right out of the top. Seed poop belongs to the tambaqui, who mostly eat fruit, seeds and all. Often the seed passes through in the poop and can form a new fruit tree somewhere else in the forest. Floating poop. Sometimes, so much air gets trapped in a sea otter's poop that it floats on top of the water. And finally, there's projectile poop. Penguins actually shoot their poop out away from their bodies to keep their feathers clean. Poop can actually tell us a lot about the health of our animals here at the aquarium. In fact, anytime we get a new animal, we'll check a poop sample to see if they have any parasites, to make sure they're digesting well.
You could tell that just from looking at poop.
Yeah, we can tell a lot from poop, no matter how small or big the sample is. Do you want to see some right now?
Yeah.
All right, guys, you're going to need to put on some gloves. When checking an animal's poop, it's important that the sample is fresh. We have a refrigerator in our laboratory for just poop and other biological samples. No human food allowed in here. Have any of you ever seen bird poop before?
Mm-hmm.
Any friends gotten pooped on?
Yes.
Bird poop actually has three parts to it. There's the brown poop part, there's the white urates, and then the clear is the urine. Today we're gonna kind of look at and be able to tell what the animals eat, sort of how the poop smells, and then the consistency of it. So, this comes from one of our tortoises up in the Amazon, one of the redfoot tortoise. So they're herbivores, so their poop doesn't smell as much, but they have all this kind of bits of hay and grass in their poop. Here's the penguin poop I was talking about. So see how liquidy this is? So they can kind of projectile that out so it doesn't get on their feathers. You guys like the sea otters we have here?
Yeah.
Do you know what they eat?
Shrimp?
Yeah. So they don't have anyone to kind of take the shells off their shrimp
that
for them. So they just eat it whole and then they poop it out because they can't digest it. So our next poop sample, this is from one of our bigger animals. It's our anaconda. So what do you think you're seeing in these poop samples?
Fur. I see fur.
Yeah, good job. For our last sample, I saved one of our stinkiest ones. It comes from our sea lions. Any guesses what they eat?
Fish.
Yeah, good job.
So is that why it gets so stinky?
Yeah, most carnivores, because they're eating a lot of protein, it gives them this stinky poop.
Nice. Poop samples. They want to taste them?
No,
no
way!
It's good.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
It's just candy.
Thanks for spending time with the Aquarium Adventure Club.
Stay curious.